return trip to Miami Fashion Week. You launched the collection here this time last year. Tell me a little bit about your return trip and why you came back.
I love showing in Miami. It was a great stepping stone for the first collection, and we, you know, got so much buzz and so much press out of it, and it really created a really excitement over the brand. And we've been around for a while. We've been around for 12 years, and this was a new thing for us, and we really wanted to do it the right way. And it's great. It's perfect. It really, from a design perspective, when you do a runway show, it helps you get very focused, and it helps you push yourself to do something more exciting than maybe you would if you were thinking about it like purely for department stores or something.
Now, you also show twice a year in New York as well. So, tell me how this is different, showing in Miami versus your shows in New York.
I mean, I love New York. I live in New York, but I would so rather have every runway show in Miami. It's just, it's very laid back, and it's really just about a show, and people are here to have fun and have drinks. And, you know, in New York, it gets probably a little jaded sometimes. They're like, they want to get the show over. They want to just look at the looks, but here it's a little more of a party. I like that. We see a lot more one pieces than ever. I really feel like that's important going forward. The styles are very clean and minimal, and that does reflect the Tibby Spring 10 collection, what we're doing, which is very early 90s inspired. So clean and minimal shapes, but we've got all the fun jewelry and the prints and the whole like flash thing too. It's a good mix.
Right now, you're also known for your prints and all your beautiful colors. Tell me about the inspiration for your designs.
The inspiration for the designs really is back with Indonesia, and each season four swim, I will be pulling from my Indonesian roots. That's where, when I started the collection, I did all my prints out of Indonesia. And when I was trying to define like how would Tibby look different than the competition, I decided to go back to what I used when I started the collection. So I think I'll keep picking up on the Indonesian theme, but be doing like a little different twist to it. And so this season, it's more like Bali meets Cannes. The colors are mixes of very bright and bold, strong colors mixed with very muted and kind of little chicer colors. We have a really big European clientele, and you know, those customers are used to wearing Erez and Etro and Missoni and a lot of collections that have very muted colors to it, and I find that very appealing aesthetically, but I also like things bright and bold and fun. And what I always try and do in my swim collection is to merge the two. So you can have the chic like slate grays and ochres, but you mix it with hot pink and bright yellow, and it gives it a different twist. One thing that we did do to differentiate ourselves from the competition was we went to really, I think, one of the highest levels of the swim fabric that you can get. And I just thought on the contemporary price point to offer something that really is an Erez quality is very exciting. And then we really stuck with the chiffons and the cottons and the jerseys. It's, I think for swim, it's really important to use a lot of natural fibers. Well, I mean, it's, you know, it's crazy, and it's really a whole year-long process. I mean, just while I'm down here on Monday, I went vintage shopping, looking for stuff for fall 10. Yeah, fall 10. So you really are always working a year out, and I think when I was down here last year doing this swim show, I was already thinking about what I wanted to do next year for swim, and now I'm already thinking about next year's swim, too, so...